how your situation differs a little bit.
Good question. So I started my company in 1982. There was very little understanding of what the style of California wine ought to be. I had worked at Zacca Mesa, a house style less property from 1977 until 1980. I went down to Australia and I worked in the Hunter Valley, and then I worked in the Goulburn Valley, and I kind of took my style from California and imprinted it. This may be something that Tom and Michael and James will say I'm totally full of shit, but in 1981, I believe I was the third person in Australia to ferment Chardonnay in barrel. And then I took insult to injury and I fermented the Gewurztraminer in barrel in the Goulburn Valley, and I was attacked by every other winemaker like they wanted to burn me at the stake. Just to let you know, in my winery now, every single wine we make, from the lightest, brightest white to the richest white to all the reds, get fermented in barrel or aged in barrel and put through malolactic fermentation, so it's become something that's embedded in my style. But at the end of 81, I went to Burgundy, and I worked in Volney with Gerard Cotel, and then I did the harvest with a now defunct winery in Chassagne Morochet that was called the Domaine Duc de Magenta. And there I was made aware of something that Antoine will embrace. He'll curse, he'll fight, or he'll enjoy for the rest of his life. And in Burgundy, as a great or somewhere in the middle winemaker, no matter how much you achieve, you have to be constrained by your village, your vineyards, and what their possibility is. And you could add a soupçon of love, you can add a little change in winemaking, but very few people will stand up and say, I dominate my neighbors.